But for 3 weeks, Holly and Jimi have been on the run, but they've left their rivals for dust to reach a nail-biting finale, outsmarting a team of highly trained experts to become the 2023 Hunted winners. Please welcome Jimi and Holly! I mean, it's hard to believe you weren't on the same team watching you congratulate each other.
I know.
This looked pretty hectic. How do you feel after all this?
I've got to admit, like, 3 weeks on the run as fugitives, I've got to say, after watching it back, the only hunch that the Hunters had about Ed and I was, oh, they're gay, so we're going to go look at the gay festival for them. I think we had them the whole time. I reckon they had no
idea. I agree. But they can pull out all sorts of things, some of which I, watching at home, just find so frightening, like the car trackers and all of that. So, really, how do you even have a chance?
Yeah, look, it's so scary. You don't know what to expect. You don't know the resources they have, the intel they have. You're really going in blind for the whole thing, and that's definitely how I felt. But I think the main thing for us is to stay ahead of the Hunters. You always have to assume they have access to everything, unlimited resources, and you always have to assume that they're hot on your trail to stay ahead.
And you made it to the extraction point without your partners. You won the 100 grand. Are you going to split it with the other guys, or is it just like straight down the middle?
Come on.
I've got to admit, something that wasn't shown on TV all that much was Ed talking about his hair transplant a lot.
And Turkey.
It would break my heart if he couldn't go to Turkey and get his hair transplant, so he's getting 25 grand. I know, he's a beautiful boy, I tell you.
In Turkey, hair transplants are cheap.
I know.
You could probably slip him, you know, 500.
Well, if you reckon, Kate, if you say that I only have to give him 500, I reckon I'll do that.
Well, lock it in. Now, I wanted to... I was very stressed out watching the end of it here. Holly, you had an issue with the fence going over there. Can you talk us through what happened there?
That fence is the bane of my existence. OK, if there's a Hunted All-Stars, I will be doing high jump practice. Honestly, look, I thought, I'm a tiny girl, I'm a little girl, I've got chihuahua legs, I didn't know how I was going to make it over that fence. I don't want to break my legs. Yeah, exactly, there I am. I didn't want to break my legs before I made it to the helicopter.
I thought adrenaline would get you over
it. Just jump.
Yeah, I know.
But no.
No, well, you're not logically thinking in that position. Like, you've got so much stress, panic, you know, you've got people chasing you. You're not really thinking clearly in that moment, and I obviously wasn't. But look, I'm copping a lot of heat for it now, so next time I will definitely jump the fence.
Aww. So what happens now? You're both obviously very good at running away. Is a life of crime next?
I've got to say, I just don't think I could be a fugitive moving forward. I'm really casting myself next as, like, going on Below Deck Down Under and being that one deck stew that they find out after four episodes lied on their resume and has never been on a yacht before and gets sacked.
It's much more fun.
Yeah, much more fun.
But still a small slice of criminality involved.
Yeah.
So,
exactly.
They're too adorable to be crooks. Look at them. Look at those faces.
That's the cover.
Yeah, that's what makes them perfect.
Oh, Sarah. Well, congratulations again. All the best with the money, splitting it or not. Would you please thank Holly and Jimi?